Welcome to video 26 on the Yamaha Montage and Modix synthesizers. In this video, we are going to make a MIDI recording. Let's take the performance we created in the previous video as a starting point. And press the performance button, and over here we see a play rec field, and let's just tap that and see what happens. Well, we open up the play and recording screen, and we see that there are three possible ways to make a recording: a MIDI or audio, which will create a .wav file, or pattern recording, which again is MIDI. That is too much for one video, so let's in this video only concentrate on a MIDI song recording. Before recording anything new, we want to make sure that over here it says new song, which means that it found a new free slot. As we can see, if I rotate the dial wheel, I already have a couple of recordings, and If we look close, then we see all of a sudden here a link icon, and that means that with my recording of the One Note Samba, it is linked to the performance called One Note Samba. That is important. If you open a song that you recorded earlier, it automatically can also open the performance with which you recorded it, so that the MIDI plays back as it should. However, this can be confusing because, as you see, now I have gone to another recording and I want to find this new song 13 again, but now it's stuck with a performance that I don't want. So what I need to do now is go back to my selection of the performance, select performance 25 again, press this performance field again, or button again, and go back. And now I have the correct video 25 sound that I want to record here in new song 13. And we see that this icon, that it is not yet linked. It becomes linked automatically when I start recording or when I change this name. So let's do that. Let's just change that name. By the way, we see that there's also a load function here, so we can load a previous created recording. But right now I'm going to rename it. I'm going to call it Video 26, which is a bit peculiar because the sound that we use is Video 25. But okay, let's make some chaos. And now we see over here this icon is linked, which means the song that is not yet recorded, but we are going to do that in a second. The song called Video 26 is linked to the sound of Video 25, called a performance called Video 25. Okay, let's simply press the record button on the synth. That is the button with the round circle above it. And now we see all of a sudden we got two new fields. We can decide to either record the arpeggios or not. Well, in this case, I have a nice drum and bass arpeggio going on, so I like to record it. We can also change the tempo. I'm going to slow it down a little bit to 96. And we can also use the quantizing function. I plan to record just four chords on the measure, on the beat. So let's quantize it on the beat, and that should take care of any tempo troubles that I make. Well, let's press the play button, and that will give us four count in, and then we start to play. Here we go. Alright, recording done. Now we see a couple of other fields. We can play it back, of course, by simply pressing the play button, but we also can loop it. It has a loop start and a loop end. Well, I played four beats, so let me put that at five. and loop it, and then hear what we hear, listen what we hear if we play back. Well, that's great. So you can make this loop and then practice a solo part or whatever you like to do. That's of course a convenient function to have. We can also add something more to a recording that we already made. Let's try that out. When we press record again, then we notice that there's again a new field, and that is the record type, which currently is on replace, which means when I start playing, what I just played will be deleted and will be replaced by what I now play, which is of course convenient when you made an error while playing and you have to do it all over again. But we can tap this field and see some other options like overdub, which means the things that we now play will just be added to what was already recorded, which is great if you now would like to add a little solo or whatever. And then we also have punch, and if we do punch, that means that we can select the point where it will start automatically recording and where it will stop automatically recording. So when you made a mistake in a small area and just want to change one or two chords, you can do that. Right now we are going to do replace or overdub, that doesn't matter, because we are going to use the function to alter the start position, and we are going to start recording at measure 5, but and I only am going to add 4 new chords to what we already had. Here we go. We now have 8 measures recorded, so we can set the loop point at 9. And we also see, if we make a change, that all of a sudden this store song and performance settings field lights up. That's what we can do now. If we press or tap that field, then it says please keep power on. Well, it just takes a few seconds, so we didn't have a chance to put the power off, but it has now stored this song, MIDI song, with this performance and with all these settings. The loop is on and the loop start point and the loop end point, that is all now saved, so when we recall it, it will be opened in exactly this same state. What we can also do is save this as a MIDI file. It is automatically saved on the Montage Modix synthesizer, but suppose we like to put it on a USB stick, that is possible of course, but then we need to have a USB stick plugged in, which at the moment I have not, because I have my video plugged in. So it asks me, please connect a USB device. I cannot show it, but it's quite easy. You tap that save MIDI file field, and then of course here it automatically selects MIDI file for you, and if you have a USB stick plugged in, you will see it over here and you can give it a file name and so on. That will work perfectly well. Another field that lights up once we added something to an existing recording is this undo MIDI record field. It's meant to undo the last edits that we made. So if we made a little mistake, just tap that field and the last part of the recording will be deleted, but the parts that we already created before will still remain. So what we have now is a performance and a song linked together. What we can do is place this combination on the live set screen for quick recall. To do that, from this recording screen, press the shift and live set buttons simultaneously, click click, And there we have it. I already did that, as we can see over here, but I'm going to do it again. And there we have it, the performance number 25, video 25, linked to the song video 26, as we can see also by this little label. And if I open this performance, it opens, of course, the performance screen. But if I go back to recording, I have all these settings that I saved it with, immediately available. What we can do, by the way, if we have a recording, we can play along. Let me take out all these arpeggios and other things that I don't need. Only play the piano and then press the play button that opens that screen. And I can now play along. Let's take out that loop and let's see if I can make something of this. Right, so you can record something and then let it loop and you can practice whatever you want. Well, I think this was it. The final part of the video. Let's have one more listen to what we just created.